Whoa, here I come.
Where's the respect?
You niggas shut up, the respect ain't here. Whoa, here I come. It's the Pink Dungeon. Man, it's your boy, Eric, a.k.a. Young God, coming to you live in the Pink Dungeon. Ah, nigga, get it to your real raw rugged. And I am back in here to talk about Pusha T and Drake. Not gonna lie, I just woke up, I'm a little tired. I might have to reshoot this video, but you know what? I'm always one take Willie, so we just gonna keep going through with this. All right, so let's get right into it. This young man, Drake, you know, he went on to the shop. You know, your boy D-Respect, the nigga y'all be asking about in the comments. I don't even know who that nigga is, man. Where's D-Respect? Nigga, listen to the theme song, nigga. Nigga, not here. Do I need to hit a duck on y'all, niggas? Because the nigga's not in this small-ass room. If D-Respect the music in this room, boy, I'm talking about, nigga, I be sweating, nigga. This room is only big for one nigga, and I am the one nigga in here, man. Anyway, your boy D-Respect did the video talking about LeBron and them boys on the shop. Shout LeBron. It's a pretty good show. And they discussed a lot of things, one being Pusha T. Basically, Drake was talking about the Pusha T thing more in detail. You know, he said, I mean, I wanna fucking punch him in the face, guy. He said, guys like fucking Pusha T need to get fucking punched in their fucking face. Hey, when a nigga say he gonna fucking punch you in the fucking face, he probably not gonna fucking do a fucking thing. So that's a little insight on life, man. If a nigga say, hey, dude, I'll fucking punch you in the fucking face. If you said an F word that many times, he ain't about nothing, bro. I'm telling you, bro. You don't even gotta be scared, man. If a nigga told me he gonna punch me in my fucking face and fucking get, nigga, if you gonna get your ass home somewhere, man. That was that nigga white side right there talking. Anyway, that was a little interesting part right there. And he also started talking about 40, how he went too far, and how he studied battle raps for a living. First of all, that's hilarious. A nigga studying battle rap for a living, that shit crazy. Imagine that's a nigga job, man. Nigga don't watch every battle rap in the world. I'm a battle rap fan. Drake, I know, is a battle rap fan for me being a battle rap fan, but that nigga don't goddamn study battle rap for a living. That nigga said that shit, that's his job or whatnot. So I thought that was pretty funny. And like he said, Pusha went too far talking about MS and 40, which is crazy because if you study battle rap for a living, you know that niggas do not hold anything back in battle rap. When you battle rapping, everything is gloves off, man. So I thought that was kind of weird that he kind of contradicted himself, because if you really study battle rap, you know what's going on. What else did he talk about? Like I said, I don't write no notes for this. I'm just going on top of my head. But yeah, you get the gist, man. I'm pretty sure y'all have seen the video. It's viral by now. So then your boy Pusha T come back on the Joe Budden podcast this morning, and it was a pretty good episode. Shout out to Joe Budden. He's putting out some pretty good content as of what, the past like 2-3 years, man, since he's been on his run or whatever, his little media run. He's been doing pretty good. So kudos to him. Anyway, the nigga Pusha T go on there. Pusha T basically divulged some information that the listeners, we do not know. First of all, the nigga say he got the baby rumors, the everything about all the dirt he got on Drake. The person that he got it from was a girl that was sleeping with 40, right? Everybody thought that he probably got it from Kanye because Drake said he sent pictures of Kanye to his baby. I mean, that nigga Drake sent a picture to Kanye to goddamn Paris. I mean, to North and shit. No, he sent pictures of his baby to Kanye. He sent pictures of like his house. He sent all these pictures to Kanye, and he thought that basically Kanye gave it a Pusha and was like, bro, expose this nigga. No, that's not what happened, according to Pusha. Pusha said he got it to a girl that was pillow talking with this nigga 40. Which is crazy because now 40's in a weird predicament, man. Because I don't know, man. Drake is a ruthless nigga, man. Everybody say that nigga got mob ties, you know what I'm saying? I heard that shit, nigga, allegedly, man. I hope when that nigga come for me, man. But shit, from what I be hearing, man, that nigga be getting niggas done for, you know what I'm saying? You know, you done know. Ain't that nigga, don't nigga want to be Jamaican and shit or UK or whatever? You done know, man. That nigga be getting niggas, you done for, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to fuck with Drake, man. So for 40 to be out in business like that, ooh, shit, man, I ain't gonna lie, man. It might be tick, tick, tick season, bro. I'm not gonna lie, man. It might be coming up because, yo, when I don't know. Drake might send that nigga Bach at him, man. And we all know Bach is not nice. So I don't know about this, man. This is gonna be a very, very interesting little couple days. See what come out the little OVO camp. See if they release anything. See if any rumors leak or anything. It's gonna be interesting, man. Because if that's actually true, wow. I get it, bro. When you like a girl, bro, you divulge information to her that you wouldn't divulge to anybody else, man. Because when you keep something on your mind, keep something on your soul, you kind of want to tell somebody. So I get it. I ain't even gonna be mad at 40, bro. I get it, bro. And then when you find a girl, when you a sucker for love ass nigga, man, and you find a girl that you think might be the girl of your dreams, man, you start talking to her, you start opening up to her. She's the person that you're most vulnerable around ever, man. Probably next to your mama, bro. Your mom and your girl, the two people you most vulnerable around, the two people you ain't scared to cry around. So if he felt that way about her to be pillow talking, he probably was falling in love with old girl. But a nigga Pusha said she ain't even care about the nigga, and that show these hoes be so cutthroat, man. These hoes be so cut, man. Hoes be so super slimy, man. These hoes that listen to Future Thug and now they super slimy. Go to their goddamn Instagram bio. They got Super Slime King or Super Slime Queen slash in their bio and shit, man. This shit is crazy, bro. I feel for 40, man, because I'm not gonna lie, bro. When you find a girl you like, man, you be opening up to her, man. You be opening up. You give it to all, man. And then she go and turn and tell this nigga Pusha T, tell this nigga with braids in his head that Drake got a baby and all this other stuff. Oh man, come on, man. Baka, you gotta send Baka on her ass. Forget Drake. I mean, forget 40. I feel you, 40. Somebody send Baka on old girl, man. Hey, don't that nigga used to like goddamn sell women and shit? I'm pretty sure that nigga get a job, man. That nigga ain't shit. No, that nigga do not respect women at all. Go send Baka not nice at her, man. Cause goddamn, Miss Super Slimy Slat Lady, goddamn, she got that nigga the fuck out of here, man. So then he also plays audio where Drake is sending people that Pusha knows has worked on Pusha albums, right? And this nigga Pusha, he gets the audio of they going to like his childhood friends, I'm guessing niggas he used to be in the street with, and they like, yo, we'll give you 100k if you give me some like juicy information about him. Going to his old DJs, and he, I guess the person that they went to, he recorded it. So he was like, bro, I'm gonna send it to you. And it's crazy because he didn't even rock with bro no more, like pushing him, that they had like a little friction. But he was like, bro, we, you know what I'm saying, we're going through a little differences, but I ain't gonna never sell you out like that. Like, we all Virginia niggas still. That's some solid nigga stuff. That nigga is solid. That nigga solid. But that nigga bend no break, you feel me? But I don't think that nigga bending, man. That nigga right there, salute, man. Cause I ain't gonna lie, nigga. Nigga Drake come to me 100k, nigga. Goddamn, what you wanna know, nigga? Hope you all ears. Hope you got a notepad, nigga. Nigga, I'm finna go down this nigga whole lineage, boy. I'm finna snitch on this nigga daddy, his brother's uncle, the nigga in jail for selling CDs at a barbershop. I am snitching, you hear me? So shout out to that nigga, man, cause I fuck with bro, man. I need niggas like that in my circle. So yeah, that was played. He played some of the audio, which is crazy, that the fact that they recorded that and he played it. I thought that was pretty interesting. What else was Devotion, that podcast? He also talked about like Kanye working with Drake and how, like, he ain't diss Kanye, but he was just some shit like, I'm a street nigga, so I ain't gonna hold niggas that's not street niggas to the street code, because I know these niggas ain't street niggas. He was like, he said his daddy always told him something. Everybody not built like you, so you can't expect niggas to move how you move, which is some 100 real shit right there. You cannot expect niggas to move how you move. Yeah, this ain't even for a street nigga, but if you move a certain way and you see a homeboy, you see niggas you cool with moving the other way, and you know they, well, not your homeboy, but just niggas that you built friendship off of like something else other than like real friendship. Like Drake ain't, I mean, not Drake, but Kanye and Pusha built friendship off of music, right? They didn't build friendship off of, oh, you're cool, we need to be friends. They built friendship off of platform. So when you build a friendship with a nigga like that, or with niggas like that and that type of feel, you gotta realize that niggas probably ain't moving like you, cause y'all ain't grow up together. Y'all ain't grow up off the same principles, you know? Cause niggas that grew up with Pusha, they probably move off the same principles, cause they from the same area. They from the same probably set of rules, you know? The families probably know each other, so they rocking like that. But niggas, but that's an interesting little point he made. Also, they're from different states. Like, it's just too much to go into it. So I think that's really interesting that he pointed that out. That I'm not even mad at Kanye for producing for Drake, even though we beefing, writing for Drake or whatever, even though we beefing, because that nigga ain't moving how I'm moving. I respect him for looking at a situation like that. I think that's a real smart way to look at it, a not emotional way, and a very logical way to look at it. A lot of niggas these days move off emotion, you know? Oh, he did this, I'm mad, but he sat there and thought about it. I ain't gonna lie, I'm a nigga that like to think I look at stuff as logical, but I probably would have moved off emotion on that one. I probably just been like, nigga, this nigga ain't riding or die for me, you know? But he said, this ain't a Rough Riders, this ain't built off ride or die, this is built off some music stuff, you know? We ain't grow up together, we ain't all street niggas. So I thought that was a pretty cool little pinpoint he put right there. But yeah, I'm very curious what this nigga Drake's gonna say, man, because nigga OVO looking real funny right now, man. You got OVO 40 goddamn talking to the plug and shit, man. telling and stuff. But like I said, I ain't even mad at 40 because I get it, man. I don't know how much he in love with this girl. But also, you can't be no sucker for love ass nigga, man. I don't know this girl. I don't know if she was a hoe or not. Because if this girl like some Instagram model, oh, 40, nigga, don't do it. All right, bro. Don't come out this shit like Bernice Burgos. Nigga, Bernice Burgos is by a grandmama age and she look young. She look beautiful. But nigga, Bernice Burgos look like she be snitching, telling, sipping the tea, all of that, boy. So I really pray to God this wasn't no fine Instagram model. And because, bro, you know, they don't got no morals, bro. Look at a girl on the Instagram model page, nigga. They do not look like they smart. They don't got no type of brains. So I really pray to God that you ain't divulge all that information to an Instagram model, because them girls will talk in a minute. You hear me? So I don't know, man. It's a really interesting little segment going on. And lastly, I want to touch on people saying that Pusha's just clinging for Drake all he can. Well, Drake, you know, he came back on the shop and, you know, started talking or whatnot. But I think that I don't even care if anybody's clinging on this beef right now, Drake or Pusha, because, bro, I'm not gonna lie, this is a very interesting little beef right here, man. I know this niggas ain't finna get shot over this, I highly doubt. Well, I don't know, man. Niggas might turn up on 40, man. But I don't know. I like it. I think this is very interesting. We haven't had something this interesting in hip hop in a very long time, so I'm all for it, man. I don't think they should stop clinging on to it. If it's something to cling on to, nigga, cling on to that thing. You hear me? So I'm all for it. Until next time, I say what I mean what I say. Haters gonna hate it. Players gonna play. I let you buy them, man.